Yeah, so what you just saw was, of course, writing a component completely from scratch. But in many situations, what you want to do is rather to take something existing and modify it just a little bit. And I was thinking a good candidate for a small project on that would be to, via some very simple means, try to hack a CSNS source, because we have no CSNS source in this. So my proposal is that there are three different ways you can try. And you can actually completely yourselves decide if you want to use one path or the other. But the idea would be that you take the source Maxwell 3 component that we use for many of the exercises. And what you will do is add a time structure in an extend block. Okay? So you already saw the use of extend. This is something that goes in the instrument file. So actually, in the first case, you don't even have to modify anything in a component. So all you would do is you would glue an extend, and then, just like Eric demonstrated in writing the component, you would add some C syntax that gives a meaningful value to T. T, that's the neutron time. Okay? So this you would handle entirely in your instrument file to add a time structure to this source. Another approach would be to get a copy of source Maxwell 3, call it something like CSNS source, my CSNS source, whatever you like, open it up, and then introduce a time constant, so a pulse length, and then maybe a logarithmic time, a tail, or something like that. This is what you would add. There's a third approach, which is to take one of the simplest pulsed components we have. So we have a component called moderator. This has a time structure, but the spectrum is flat. So the idea would be that you introduce something that's flat. So a spectrum in the way there. So basically it's kind of, it's looking at both of these and trying to make your own marriage between the two. So the proper way to then proceed, once you have something like that, of course we would need to have the intensities right. One of the ways to start on that process, that would be to take, together with the DPPD instrument that was contributed from here, there is a model of the CSNS decoupled hydrogen, which is from an MCNP run. And what you could do is you could measure that, what the output is, using McStas components, and then you could do some fits to get an idea of the good values of the spectrum. So this could be a couple of Maxwellians maybe to do that. So the right solution, I would say, for the future, that is probably to engage with the people that do calculations for the target and operators at CSNS. And then you would do a procedure like this, at least for each of the moderators, preferably maybe even for each beamline position. And then what I've put in the GitHub also is a document from Franz Gellmeyer at the SNS. So it includes a couple of PDFs and some, basically a series of fits. So I don't provide his code for the fits, but at least the theory is described in the documents. And what it is, I believe in the spectrum side, it's an Ikeda-Carpenter function that is used per time slice. And then these are stitched together in the other dimension by means of a so-called Pade function. So that's something to get used on. Then I also have a quick and dirty temporary solution, and I asked Klaus Leutnant if he thought this would be okay, and I believe he does think this is okay. One way is to take VTES 3.4 as it is, and then generate MCPL output from that. So he has three models of the CSNS sources. And of course, this will be very straightforward and quick to do. So you just have a file, which is limited statistics, generated NBI tests, and then you can do the rest of the transport in MCTAS. The advantage is it's very straightforward and it's quick to do. It's a disadvantage in the sense that you don't have a lot of control over the process, and it's certainly slower than an analytical solution. And I experimented yesterday. I think I may have uploaded three versions of such an MCPL file. And the limit, if we keep it in GitHub, will be something like 3 to the 6. Yeah, so that's already 100 megabytes.
So what's your gain that use the Maxwell?
In terms of time? It's a little hard to say. I would say, and maybe we should actually do a little benchmarking on that. That's also a project for this open session if you wish. So you do a normal calculation, say with source Maxwell, you transport that through a guide, or you try transporting this through a guide. Then we get a proper number for that. My experience is that it's easily effective. Yeah, it's a waste. Good. Yeah, so I realize this is really very compact and really extremely open, so I hope it's still useful. That's in fact all I have for this. So what I will do is I will leave these three, this slide with these three topics on the screen. And then we proceed. You pick one of these approaches, you try to do something, work with your colleague at the site, and then the rest of us will walk around and try to assist you. That's the idea. I hope it's not too open. We should see. Yes. So three different projects. Try to do a CSNS in the instrument file by means of adding a time structure in the instrument file. Another is trying to edit one of these components as a starting point, to either add the spectrum to a pulsed source or add a pulsed structure to a component that has a spectrum. Yes.